Welcome to a short training video designed to introduce you to the different tools and features found in Google Earth. These training videos are designed to assist you in creating and presenting your information to others in a geographic context. This video is part 7 in a series where you'll be learning to create image overlays that will allow you to import scanned print maps or photos and view them within your project. As you present your projects, you may find it interesting to add an image overlay for additional information within your project. This process works by applying images flat on the Earth's surface or three-dimensionally on the terrain. For this tutorial, I'll be adding a shuttle bus map around the University of Utah to my project. For others to view an image overlay, I first need to find or make an image available on the internet with an active URL link. There is currently a shuttle map on the web that I'd like to use, so I'll go ahead and navigate to it, select the image, and right-click to copy the image location. I can now return to Google Earth and begin my overlay by selecting the Add Image Overlay tool from the toolbar. In the dialog box, I want to paste the URL in the link box, and if the link is correct, I should immediately see the image on my screen. I'll go ahead and give this overlay a name of Shuttle Bus Routes, but I want to hold off on selecting OK at this time. The next step is to align this image to features found on the map. I first want to adjust the transparency so that I can easily see both the image features as well as the features on the map at the same time. I also want to make sure that my image is clamped to the ground by going to the Altitude tab and selecting Clamp to Ground. I can now use the green directional arrows to the sides and corners of the image to adjust and rotate it until it aligns with features on the map. This process allows me to define the image's existence within physical space using a process known as georeferencing. Georeferencing is not an exact science, so take your time and align the image as close to the real-world features as possible. Once I'm satisfied with the placement of my image, I'll go to the View tab and select Snapshot Current Image. By doing so, each time this overlay is accessed, the view currently displayed in Google Earth will be brought up. I'll now click OK and my image is saved to the My Places folder, where I can click and drag it to a desired location within my project folder. By following these steps, you can create as many image overlays for your project as you like. Anytime you need to go back and revise the information or change the snapshot, simply right-click on the folder and select Get Info if you're running a Mac, or Properties if you're running a PC. This concludes Part 7 of this series. To learn about additional features and functions and how to apply them within Google Earth, please refer to the additional tutorial videos found in this series. Thank you for viewing this podcast and for your interest in Google Earth.